Hello and welcome to the second installation of Virtual Views Film Vault Summer Camp here at the Museum of Modern Art. I'm Ashley Swinnerton, Collection Specialist in the Department of Film, and today I'm joined by Katie Trainor, Film Collections Manager, also in the Department of Film. Thanks for joining us, Katie.
Hi, everybody. I am actually sitting in our Film Study Center here at MoMA.
Nice. I'm in the Special Collections Room, which is where we keep our paper materials on site for researchers. So why don't you tell us a little bit about what you do as Collections Manager?
Will do. I mainly oversee the preservation pipeline. I also supervise the staff, the collection staff here, and our collection staff out in our preservation center in Hamlin, the Celeste Bartos Preservation Center.
So the topic this week is preservation, and really the mandate of the Department of Film is education. It was founded that way as the Film Library, and we still hold that very near and dear to our hearts even today. But without preservation, you know, there's no access. You can't screen something unless you have copies of the film.
I don't know. It says, MoMA was a co-founder in the Federation of Film Archives in 1938. This was kind of pioneering at the time, because at that moment, people in the entertainment industry didn't really consider films that were going to last. They basically just threw them away for the most part, or they burned in a fire. And so it was the thoughts of those curators and directors of those archives, and at MoMA it was Iris Berry who had the vision to see the film as an art form and the need for it to last. So thank her and her colleagues for having that vision.
Iris Berry was the first film curator here at MoMA. You can see her here in this clip with her husband, John Abbott, who was also an employee of the museum. And here they are again in the screening room, smoking.
There is some misconception about what is meant to happen when you restore film. For us, I think at MoMA, we tend to be very conservative in our restoration and preservation efforts. The way we look at it is we want to restore something to the time when it was very first projected in the theater, or what did it look like then? That is our goal. So our goal isn't to clean it up, super clean it up, so you miss every defect or every piece of dust or dirt. It's to make it look like it was for when it was first screened. So and when I say conservative, I mean we don't. I call what I see in some film restorations the soap opera effect. they make it look like TV, like it's so clean and that it looks almost not 3D but very super high def on your TV, and I just think that takes away. I like to see the grain. I like to see the inherent filmness of certainly a film restoration that's originated on film stock.
We've picked three films from MoMA's film collection to illustrate this week's topic, preservation. The first is Lime Kiln Club Field Day from 1914, featuring Burt Williams. Next is a 1934 screen test for Joan of Arc featuring Katharine Hepburn from Pioneer Pictures. And then Andy Warhol's Kiss, produced in 1963 and released in 1964. So the first film is Lime Kiln Club Field Day from 1914. This film was never edited and never released. What we have in the collection was acquired in 1939 as part of our Biograph collection. Biograph was going out of business. They were no longer a company and liquidating all of their materials. So they called Iris Berry and said, come pick it up or it's going into the garbage. Our curators had identified Burt Williams, but that was about all they knew about the film until about 10 years ago when Ron Magliozzi and Peter Williamson started doing a deep, deep research into the history of this film, where it hit locations, the actors, trying to identify as many people as they could and piece together the history of this film and why it was never finished or released.
You might notice that Burt Williams, who is himself Afro-Caribbean, is the only actor appearing in blackface. When you watch the excerpt of Lime Kiln Club Field Day, we recorded a special introduction with our chief curator of film, Raj Roy, who explained the complicated history of that decision in the intro.
The material was in very good condition. That went back scanning the nitrate, and we did do some cleanup on that material. that would enhance the ability digitally to see things in, within the frame better. So I think that was a wise decision.
So this is a screen test featuring Katharine Hepburn for Joan of Arc, which was a role that she never played on screen. But this is both a screen test in terms of her acting abilities, but also a test of Technicolor's new three-strip process that they hadn't quite perfected yet. So you will see, you know, some variations in the color, and it's not perfect because they hadn't quite figured it out yet.
Right, because everybody immediately thinks Technicolor is this, you know, all these bright reds and blues, when there were these various processes that had, there was an evolution in the Technicolor process. So, I mean, I think there were a lot of screen tests like that happened at that time, especially when they were testing the Technicolor process of unrealized projects, but this is just one of many. I mean, she would have been a great Joan of Arc, right?
So the final film is Kiss by Andy Warhol. Typical Warhol is atypical.
Yeah, typical. That's very good. That's very good. Typical Warhol is atypical.
You know, this is almost an hour of people just making out.
Yes, you have a man and a woman kissing, a woman and a woman kissing, a man and a man kissing, and then man kissing this another man, and then the same person kissing that woman. So whether they filmed at factory or Chelsea hotel or home or something like that, it's just him having an idea to film something and then doing it. And in all honesty, if nobody's ever seen a Warhol film, there's nothing you can say about it is gonna
prepare them
any easier for them.
I feel like Katie is the perfect person to talk about the Warhol Digitization Initiative. She is our point person with the Warhol Museum in Pittsburgh.
The digitization of these films is relatively simple with the Warhol. You'll notice a difference when you see, if you were to watch these in order, the Lime Kiln Club, Field Day, the Katharine Hepburn screen test, then the Warhol, they all look different. And with the Warhol, you'll notice some dust and dirt, some scratches. And we decided to do very little with the Warhol because his films were always just screened as is and often prints over and over again. I don't ever been his intention to clean them up the way we did, for instance, with Lime Kiln Club. We worked very closely with a curator from the Andy Warhol Museum, Greg Pierce, who knows Warhol's film work very well. And we just decided what we would do a one pass. And that means this very subtle contrast for black and white, you know, contrast changes. And for any of the color material, very simple color correction. No post-digital work on scratch removal or dust removal. Of course, we cleaned them first, but we just wanted to keep it as if it would look like if you were projecting a film at the factory.
Well, I hope you enjoyed this week's Virtual Views Film Vault Summer Camp. You can find more videos on MoMA Magazine and our YouTube channel. And stay tuned for the rest of August for more films from MoMA's film collection. Films from film collection. That sounds great. See you next week.